Okay, welcome back. Today we have a video on HO FlexTrack from three different manufacturers and several different rail heights. So let's get started. The first one I got here is from a company called Microengineering, and it is code 100. They've got another version with the same ties basically, which is code 83. And for those of you who don't know, the 100 and the 83 just means the height of the rail in thousandths of an inch. I'll give you a little bit of a close-up look at it here. And as you can see, ties are quite skinny and pretty good spacing on them. The 83 basically has the same ties, I think. I don't think the spacing's much different either, but the rail height obviously is a little shorter there. Okay, a lot of people like the 83, it's popular. The next brand is Atlas, which is pretty popular, been around a long time. And they have an 83, a 100, and also, that's it on theirs for them. The 83, similar to Microengineering, but you can see that the ties are a little bit fatter and spacing's a little bit different. 83 is pretty popular from Atlas. It's easy to buy, so it has some popularity there. Their 100 is very old. It's been around a very long time, and looking at the ties there, they are quite fat, a little bit short and stubby, a little unrealistic, and the tie plates are huge. I'm not a big fan of code 100 in Atlas. I think it's came out in the 70s or something, so it's kind of a relic there. But they still make it. Okay, and then we also have Pico, which is a company in England, and they make everything in England. They don't offshore anything. They've got 83, 75, and 100. So let's take a look at the 83. It's similar to Atlas's 83. They've got the skinnier ties. They've got a nice spacing on them, and the tie detail is pretty well hidden, so it's a nice piece of track, this 83, for modeling American railroads. The 75 and the 100 are kind of similar. Their ties look to be about the same. I think the biggest difference is the tie plate detail is more prominent and sticks up more than in the 75. It's more hidden. It's a little cleaner look there. But here's a close-up of the 75 for you. And it's really realistic. I really like this one a lot. And the 100 is there a little bit older. They've had it for a while. They've got also sectional track, and we'll talk about that in a minute. So you have seven kinds to choose from. You should choose the one that you really like the looks of. They're all pretty reliable, but I'm going to give you a few takeaways here right quick that I observed when comparing them all. Any of the 83s are going to have skinny ties, okay? So if you want that skinny tie look, then you need to be looking at any of the 83s. The snapback is something that happens on Atlas. I'll demonstrate right quick here. If you go like this and you go like that, okay, I call that the snapback, and the other brands don't do that. For example, here's Microengineering. See, it didn't do that when I bent it. Pico doesn't do it either. I'll prove it to you. So that's a bit of a feature that people don't like about Atlas. This is the snapback. It's harder to mount it on the table a little bit. You'll have to look at that if that's a factor or not for you. The sectional pieces, if you want sectional, you're going to be focusing on Pico 100, Atlas 100, and Atlas 83, because there are no sectionals for Microengineering, and there's no sectionals for Pico 75 or 83. Okay, and the turnouts, this is a matter of opinion. My opinion is that Pico has the best turnouts in the world. I know some people will disagree with that, but a lot of people will agree with that. I'd probably say 80%. If you're worried about turnouts, reliability second to none with Pico. If you're worried about where they're made, Pico is making everything in England. Atlas is always China. Microengineering, right here in the USA, in Missouri, I believe. So if you might consider that as part of one of your factors. And finally, they have nice catalogs available for Pico. They have a track only catalog, which is free. I'll put the part numbers in the body of the YouTube summary area. They also have their complete catalog, which you can buy, has everything they make besides track. Beautiful catalog. Really impressed with their stuff. And they tell you how to make things and put things together, and it's really nice. So you might want to pick up a Pico if you're interested in their stuff. Wonderful company, wonderful people. Okay, thanks for watching.